Hey guys, so in this video we will be showing you how you can use drag and drop functionality of bubble to drag elements around the web pages. So you could have a Kanban board here, like we showed you earlier in a video. You can see this pop-up here and you can see that video. So now this is an extension of that video on just focusing on the drop and drag and drop video, drag and drop tutorial. So as you can see, I can drag and drop any of this task here. So and then I can scroll this video, scroll this board as well, and then I can change all of the task status as well. So this is what we will be doing. So let's jump in right here. So to make a easy understanding of this, what we will do is we will have a drop area. So this is where you will actually drop these tasks. So this is our drop area. So as you can see, we can actually get a task from here. Let me actually reload. So as you can see, we can actually grab a task from here and then we can drag it from here and then drop in this drop area. So and then it will run the workflows which we will cover later. So as you can see, we have the basic thing is that we first of all we have to have a drop area before we can drag an element and drop it there. So as you have seen, if I move it here, so this is our drop area. So because we have task in it, so what we will do is we will make a repeating loop inside it, a repeating loop which will contain a list of tasks inside it. So those could be any number of tasks. So and then this drag loop will actually contain each of the tasks. So this drag loop, let me show you what this drag loop is. So this is actually the drag loop which we can drag. This is a single task, this is an individual task which is inside a repeating loop and which we can drag and drop here and there. So let me show you how we have built it inside the bubble. So before moving on, you will need a plugin which is Draggable Elements. So this is from the bubble. As you can see, it is by bubble. So you can just install it in your app. If you just search for drag, and it will be visible here on the top. So if you come into the design tab, I have already built it. So let me actually show you how I have built it. So we have a main board here. It is just a simple group inside which we have a drop area. So when you install this plugin, this Draggable Elements plugin, it will give you two of the elements. The one is the drop area elements and the drop area element, and the other is the drag element. Again, the drop area, this is the drop area element that is here, and this is the element that we can drag. So if you search for drop, so you can see this drop area. You have to pick this drop area and add it into the main board here. So what we have done is, let me actually hide this to remove any of confusions. So the first thing is in the what we decided here, that we needed a drop area. So this is exactly what we have done here. We have added this element, this drop area element here in the drop area task one, inside which we have a repeating loop. And with repeating loop, we have just added drop area. This is a simple group. Let me rename it. Simple group. So this is, it has nothing special inside it. It is just a basic group element which comes from bubble as default. So this is just for UX purposes. You can also you not make it and it will work exactly the same. So if you open this repeating loop, as you can see that we have added the drag element here, not the regular bubble group. So this element that has hand on it, you can actually drag this element. So we have created we have added that plugin, that element, inside which you can have just normal text inside it like you have in a simple basic loop that comes from by default from bubble. So we have done exactly that. It has just a title inside it and a multi-line input which are actually auto binding to the parent. It's just like this. You can actually modify the task title and everything, so you can actually do this. And then the thing is that what happens when you drag this element to this other area. So now there is an event that comes with this plugin. So it is called the drop area. Let me actually make it clean so we would know that we are working on it. So if you come here and you search for events, you will see a drop area has a group drop in it. And if you click here, you can select which was the drop area. So in our case, it will be drop area task 2. So let me just open that and we are marked green. So a drop area task 2 has a group drop in it. Type of thing that we want to modify is task. So we will select task from here. Now because what we are doing here is that when we, so I had a task pending here which was repaired laptop. So when I went to the this fee center in Gulberg and it was currently repairing, I can just drag this element and I can say that it is currently in progress. So what we will do is we will make the changes to the task. Now which task? So whenever so the thing to change is current workflow task that was just moved, that was just moved from here to here. So it is so bubble will give you this by default, and then what you can do is you can set its status. In my case, you can set this either give it static, or in my case, I have actually set the states drop areas group. So let me actually show you this as well. So if I open drop area task tools states, so I have just set a state like and given it a default value. It was not needed as well, it was but just to make things clear, you can set the status as this drop areas task status, and the this is how the status of the task will change. So if you currently reload this, so as you can see that the change to this task was made, and let me actually show you the debug mode as well. So it will be step by step. So let's suppose the laptop is repaired successfully, and I will move this task from in progress to completed. So now the event is triggered, the drop area 3, so this is drop area 3, has a group drop in it, so it will make the changes. Current workflows task, which task? That go to fee center for Gulberg for repair. So we need to make changes and make its status as completed. So now from where this completed is coming? It is coming from drop areas, this drop area, this third drop areas task status, which I have set to completed. So it will make this change, mark this task as completed, and this is how the workflow is completed. So if you now refresh the page, as you can see, the repaired laptop was moved successfully from in progress to the completed. So this is how you can make drag and drop functionality in Bubble and make workflows around it, and make a quick Kanban board here as well. So thank you so much for joining us today. I hope you have a good day. Bye bye.